Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we're exploring Fallout New Vegas once again. We're back here outside of the Good Springs General Store and Saloon. We're gonna go in a minute and talk to Sunny Smiles and go on her little quest. But first, we're gonna take a look at some of these things. For one thing, this would be the—I forget what it's even called. Reloading bench, right? Yeah, this is where you can break down ammo to get the, the base elements and create ammo as well from those base elements. Obviously, you can also break down scrap metal to lead. That's cool. I forgot you could do that. Apparently, you can break down scrap metal and maybe other items. That, for all I know, that might be a mod. And then this is a workbench where you can recycle energy cells. There's actually no reason not to do this, even though we can't do many of them. What else can we make here? A lot of stuff. Okay, so this is where you make, like, explosive weapons. You can also make doctor's bags and other little supportive items and things like that. So that's okay. So there's a lot of stuff here. I've never really messed with this much. I've always kind of ignored these, but I do plan on, at the very least, using this the reloading bench quite often. We're going to be getting a perk later down the line to make it easier to do all of this business. Yeah. I forget what the perk is. I forget what it even does. Oh well. Anyway, that'll be later. That'll be something we do later. Point is, I'm going to be paying more attention to that because of the fact that this is going to be a hardcore playthrough with a lot of mods to also make the game even harder and everything like that. Hello, Chet.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for.
Tell me about weapon mods and special ammo.
Weapon mods are things like silencers, scopes, bigger magazines.
Yes.
Special ammo includes things like armor-piercing bullets, which don't hurt the target as much, but let you punch through armor easier. There's also hollow point bullets, which have the opposite effect. You can kill unarmored targets easier, but they don't do shit against armor.
Uh-huh. What makes the surplus ammo inferior? That's kind of a dumb question, but we'll go ahead.
It's all about quantity over quality. Trouble is, you'll be cleaning and fixing your gun a lot more than usual when you use those kind of bullets.
Uh-huh. Know anything about the people who attacked me?
The leader was a New Vegas type. Typical city boy. He had a bunch of great cons with him, probably hired guns. The great cons normally stay in their own territory way up northwest, on account of them being enemies with the NCR.
Uh-huh. Have you ever been to New Vegas?
Twice. Both times I drank a lot of liquor and lost most of my caps at the card tables. In that order, now that I think about it. If you ever get to New Vegas, be sure to visit Gamora. It's the best casino in the city. You won't regret it. Word of advice, behave. Between the NCR military police and Mr. House's robots, you don't want to be causing trouble on the Strip.
Chet, first of all, buddy, you really shouldn't sound so surprised when you say that you got drunk and then lost all your money. Second of all, telling me I won't regret it after you just told me that 100% of your experiences with going to New Vegas involved you losing all of your money, probably not the most accurate assessment. I mean, I know some people just really love gambling and they think it's the most fun thing in the world, but no thanks, that sounds like something I would majorly regret. And if you're getting completely frickin' wasted before you do it, then you probably won't even remember any of the fun you had. Anyway, I'd like to know more about Mr. House.
I'm afraid I don't know much myself. Mr. House has got his own casino, Lucky 38, but nobody goes in or out except his robots. The other casinos follow Mr. House's rules, so I guess that makes him the leader of New Vegas. As far as I know, nobody's ever laid eyes on the guy. I think that robot who pulled you out of the dirt belongs to Mr. House. Mr. House is looking after you. It's got to be a good thing, right?
How'd you know he belongs to Mr. House? Everybody else in town thinks that he's completely lost and doesn't have any of his memory intact, and that's certainly the act he puts up, that he doesn't have any of his memory intact. Sounds like a shot in the dark on your part, Chet. Oh well. Anything else you can tell me about the Great Khans?
They're tough sons of bitches. Mean, but not crazy. They'll leave you alone unless you got something they want. The Great Khans deal in illegal chems. There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by Great Khans.
Uh-huh, so they also produce chems. Cool. Okay, show me what you have for sale, Chet.
Can do.
Can do indeed. Alrighty, oh boy. I don't know how much of this stuff I'm gonna sell. I could probably sell the... Because this only does 4 damage, 9mm pistol does 5, right? Yes. So I can probably sell this submachine gun because faster fire rate isn't really worth it. I want to, you know, ammo is pretty scarce at this point. So having a faster fire rate isn't going to really help. It's just going to really make me run down the weapon's durability much faster. And it won't be doing as much damage, so it's not really worth it. You know what, actually, let me freaking sort this. Yeah, a little easier there. I think I'm going to keep the rest of those for now. Keep that, it's the only clothing I have, obviously. Lots of food, going to need all that. Programmer's Digest. It doesn't have any weight, so I'm actually going to hold on to that. That's funny, I thought all these, like, magazines and stuff did have weight. Interesting. I suppose since they don't, they'll possibly come in handy. Might as well hold on to them. Cherry bombs. Empty syringe. Mantis egg. Those are worth quite a lot. Mantis forelegs. Not worth as much, but still, they're cool. Scrap metal, wonder glue. Wonder glue is heavy. I won't bother selling it right now, because I can use it for repairing and stuff, I believe. Alright, now what do you have that I might want? Laser pistol, plasma pistol, recharger rifle. Shovel, silence 22 pistol, single shotgun, throwing hatchet. The 22 pistol, how much damage does that do? 3? Wow, no thanks. Leather armor, pure hat, leather armor. I might want that, actually. Because my current, apparel, that has no damage resistance whatsoever. And gives me shitty extra melee skill and speech. I already have pretty high speech, and it's tagged, so I'm going to have even higher speech pretty soon, so that's not helpful, and melee weapons isn't helpful. So, yeah, I think... it's pretty heavy, but I don't remember any other armor I'm going to be getting soon. We'll be able to get riot gear pretty soon from the fight with the powder gangers. And I think that's about the same as leather armor. So I'm not sure if I... I'm not sure if that'd be worth the money. I don't think so. Maybe. Oh well, we'll see. Stim packs are fucking expensive too, at this point in the game at least. Bobby pin, can always use more of them, we'll take one. You know what? Just gonna accept that as it is. Save my money. I don't think we'll need the armor
if you need anything else.
That badly. Goodbye.
Easy.
Now that we've done that, just gonna. Oh, you're gonna sit down there, huh? Oh boy. Okay, maybe you could... Oh, whoops, detected. Just gonna stand up. If he sees me sneaking, he'll get suspicious and probably start watching me. And he just sits back down again. Okay, sure, if that's the way you're gonna be. Alright. Take... Oh, purified water. I was gonna say take all your food, but you don't have much, do you? What is that empty whiskey bottle? Oh, I couldn't even see it. It's on the... I just saw the red name pop up. Chet, stop looking towards me, please. Oh, armor case. I can probably steal that. could probably get leather armor from it. Oh, wait, hidden again? Yup. Sweet. Oh, Merc Grunt outfit. Well, damage resistance of 1, or damage threshold of 1, I should say. What? How'd you see that? I was hidden before I opened it. Sorry, that was a accident. I thought it was for sale. I was gonna offer you a price on it. Motherfucker. God damn it. My sneak skill isn't high enough. He's sitting there watching me. Fine, we'll just leave. Now I'm infamous, apparently. Because I stole one item. Whatever. I'll live with it. Alright. Normally, I think I have a higher sneak skill normally at this point in the game. What even is my sneak skill? It's only 24. Yeah. I think normally I tag sneak and I have a higher amount by this point in the game. Oh well. Hey, you.
Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Yeah, Dr. Mitchell said he could teach me to survive in the desert.
Yeah, I guess there's a thing or two I could show you. Sounds like you need all the help you can get after what they done to you. Meet me outside, behind the saloon.
Sure thing. Right over here, up on the hill. The flashing arrow on your compass shows... No, it doesn't. Oh, well, I mean, it technically does, but it's pointing to Sunny Smiles right now. I believe. Or not. Never mind. Where is it pointing? Is it pointing at the fence? The building? That's weird. Let me look at the map. Because I have a mod installed that I've never really done much testing with. It's a mod that changes... Back in the saddle. Yeah. Weird. What's this one say for that? Yeah, there's no quest marker for that one. Because we don't know where they are, and but this one there is. I guess it's pointing generally towards the back of the. Oh, okay. So now, so it is pointing towards Sunny Smiles.
See the sarsaparilla bottles on the fence there?
Take yeah.
And try to hit a couple of them.
Oh, it automatically equipped it. Thanks, game. Yeah. So I guess because she was in the building, the quest marker kind of got stuck. Alright, just, woo. There you go. Yep, I already am, thanks. Yep, I know, thanks, lady. Wow, how'd that miss?
Nice shot. Well, that's a start. But I don't reckon you came to me to learn to fight sarsaparilla bottles. Tell you what, I gotta go chase geckos away from our water supply anyway. Darn critters are attracted to it. Why don't you come along?
Sure.
Follow me. It's just down to the southeast a short ways.
Let's reload that. I'm following you. Get going. Jeez, you better hurry up, woman. Please stop. Please stop stopping. Oy. How much damage does this thing do? Items, weapons, varmint rifle. Damage 5, okay. Alright, let's go, Sunny Smiles. Pick up the pace. I've got reduced walking speed, and yet I'm still pulling ahead of you. Jesus Christ. I really hate parts like this, where you're expected to follow an NPC that you move faster than. Especially if it's like... programmed into the AI to make them walk, to make them stop walking if you get too far away from them or something like that. Fortunately, there aren't many moments like this in New Vegas that I can remember, at least. This part is certainly one that's, you know, kind of annoying, though. Because we're going particularly far away, and she does not seem to be in much of a hurry at all. Leave a. Right. I don't want any of those damn geckos
hear
to see
up
us.
Behind me there? We got some geckos to clear out.
Mm-hmm.
Monsters is what they are. Seems like Doc Mitchell treats more gecko bites than anything else. Let's see if we can get a little closer. If we move quietly, we can get the jump on them. More likely to hit something vital that way.
Yeah, that makes sense. Alrighty. Now, I don't have anything with a scope, unfortunately.
Okay, you're on. Go give him help.
So, my attempts at sniping are going to be reliant on iron sights, which means not very good. Alright, where the hell did you go? I know one went behind the bush. I don't want to move any closer because they will see me. Oh, there you go. Did that even hit? I think it did. Oh boy. This is not doing much damage at all, which is to be expected, but still. Oh, gotta reload. Damn it. Okay, I know that one hit something. Still only caution. That's pretty lucky. Nice, crit. Cool. Nice. I think that was the second one. Nice. I'm really surprised they haven't caught on to where I am and started running over here yet. Normally, enemies can tell where you are after the first time you shoot them. Hmm. Do not have much ammo left for this. Oh boy. And that dude has not come out of hiding from behind the rocks. I think there's just the two of them over there. I think it should be safe to move up. Finish him off. Oh wait, nope. There's definitely a third one. Wait, no, it's the same one. I guess he moved closer. Okay. Alright, cool. Alright, Sonny. Job's done.
See? You're getting the hang of it.
Certainly
There's
am.
Two more wells that still need clearing. You want, you can come along. It'd be worth a few caps to me.
Sure thing.
Shouldn't take more than a couple minutes, especially with two of us. Come with me.
She's gave me like a shit ton of ammo, too. That is pretty nice. Let me get the sweet, sweet gecko meat off of them, though. Oh, well, gecko hide. He had the gecko meat. And let me drink some water. Replace unpurified water with dirty water? What would be the benefit of that? Wouldn't that just turn dirty water into dirty water? I'm not sure. You know what, let's try it. What exactly is the title? Just dirty water, right? Yeah. So oh wait, I'm dumb. No, it poured out the dirty water and refilled it with purified water from the Yeah, now I have 5 purified water and I don't have any dirty water left. I was reading this wrong. It said replace unpurified water. I thought that meant like replace what water you had for unpurified water. I was just excuse me. I misread it. Point is, oh boy, she's gonna die. Okay, this is not good. Let me just take out, I think the plasma pistol has the highest damage. Right? Yeah, 8. Oh no, jammed! Why would you run ahead, Sonny? Jesus Christ. Oh, the dog's dead, unfortunately. Oh, boy. Oh, boy, oh, boy. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. Okay. You know what? Let's, put the varmint rifle on 1. Plasma pistol on 3. Laser pistol's probably not even worth using. Let's put this on 4. This on 5. This on 6. Sure. Okay, turn off the damn pit boy light. I'm sorry, Cheyenne. I'm sorry that Sunny Smiles is a dumbass and moved ahead when I wasn't with her. Moved ahead quite quickly, in fact. In fact, where the hell is she now? Oh my god. She's gonna get killed. The hell is she? All the way over there. Nope. 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 Jesus. Well, is there a third one? No? Okay. Oh, no more ammo left. Damn. Alright. Really sucks that Cheyenne died. But at least Sunny didn't die, I guess. That's nice. Oh, the other lady died, though.
Confound it, Cheyenne. Why'd you have to go running in like that? You were supposed to stay. I'm sorry. You shouldn't have to see me like this. I'm not going to be very good company right now. I did have another thing to teach. But I'll understand if you'd rather I just pay you so you could be on your way.
What'd you want me to teach about? What? Teach me about?
Thought I might teach you about living off the land and making useful things for yourself. Interested?
Couldn't hurt.
All right, then. We'll need a couple ingredients to get started. Gonna want some Xander root and a Brock flower. Let me think now. I know I've seen Brock flowers growing up at the graveyard, and I seem to remember there being Xander root over by the schoolhouse.
Yep.
Bring those on back to me, and we'll get cooking.
Yep, I already cleared out the schoolhouse of all of its Xander roots. Good spring settler. Why'd you have to die too? Oh. The field hand outfit has higher damage resistance than the other thing. The one that frickin', what's his face caught me stealing. That's interesting. Alrighty. Oh. Nothing I can grab around here. I could drink my H2O thing's going up a bit. I could drink some purified water and hope I get the water bottle back. I did lose a little bit of health, so yeah. Empty bottle added, sweet. Alright, refill that water bottle. Cool. Alright, well, one settler dead, one dog dead. Kind of surprised Sunny Smiles had a different reaction for that. I mean, I guess I shouldn't be surprised. Obsidian do know how to write games the proper way to have NPCs react to things happening. But, you know. Ooh. Suave gambler hat. Nothing else in here. So yes, that would be part of the Wild Wasteland perk, as you could see from the little notification in the top left screen there with the confused vault boy. That one right there was a reference to the fourth Indiana Jones movie, in which it has a really crappy scene where Indiana Jones, I mean, I'm sure everybody already knows about it, he survives a nuclear explosion by hiding in a refrigerator. Oh, we could put on the Swap Gambler hat. Wonder if it has no damage resistance, but plus one perception. And, what's the damn button for we look alright, I guess. Whoops. Why is that? Get out. Stop. Please. Thank you. I was trying to press my middle mouse button to put the camera back to first person, and for some reason it brought up that. I don't know what that was. I've never seen that before. It appeared to be informing me of various mods that I had activated. Which, yes, okay, good, they're still activated. Oh no! Oh shit. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Oh, damn it. Oh, damn it. Oh, damn it. Oh, damn it. Oh boy. You know what, let's finish him off with... Whoa, get away! Save my shotgun ammo if I can. Jesus, I forgot there were scorpions by the hill here. Let's sneak up there. Yeah, I can't backpedal anymore. No siree. That's a nice looking gun. I do have a mod installed which changes some of the gun models to be better looking. I've never actually... it changes quite a few, and I don't remember which ones it changes. I didn't know it changed the caravan shotgun. It looks really damn good, too. Doesn't change this at all, though. Stupid freaking BB gun. Boy. Anyway, so yeah, the scorpions dealt with. There don't seem to be any others, but there are... There's gonna be these things. These bloatflies. I almost forgot their name for a second. Whoops. Stand still. Stand still for a second. Nice. Let's reload. Wait for you to stand still for a second as well, please. Please, please. Please. No, no. You gonna just keep flying around, huh? Damn it. Wait for him to walk back in line. Damn it. There you go, got him. Oof. Reload. Oh boy, hey. Oh, you. You're pretty close. Maybe we can VATS you. 13% chance. Let's try 27. Nope. Okay. I forgot how many freaking small, fast-moving enemies there are in this game. And he just fucked off. He literally, like, ran away. Great. Let's get the other one, then. Damn it. Nope. There you go. Oh god, there's so many more that I didn't notice before. Come on, sit still for a second. Let me shoot you. Please? I don't have a shovel, do I? Yep, I need a shovel to dig here. Damn it. Discovered Good Spring Cemetery. Yeah, I know I have. Thanks. There you go. Got him. Got him. Should be one more. Yep. Nice! For a few seconds there, I suddenly became a fucking professional crackshot sniper. Let's put this gun away. I do know that down in that valley there are more scorpions. I don't think that they can notice me from all the way up here, but I don't want to risk it. Not gonna take that chance. No siree. Brock flower. Alrighty. Nothing in the grave. That's the open grave that I was in, I believe. Oh, none of these bloatflies had any meat or anything on them. That's unfortunate. Snow globe. Good springs. You found a limited edition Mojave Landmark snow globe. These rare pre-war artifacts are widely considered to be useless baubles, but rumor has it some collectors will pay dearly for them. If I remember correctly, I believe Mr. House is actually the one who pays for those. Barrel cactus fruit, prickly pear fruit, coyote tobacco chew. Okay. We need a shovel. I always forget that part. I always come up here to this grave without a shovel, and then remember I need a shovel. And then I have to go back to town and buy a shovel. So that's what we're going to go do. We're going to go get a shovel. I know for a fact somewhere in the game world is a way to get a shovel for free, but they should be really cheap to buy, and I have no idea where we would get one of these free shovels. So we're just gonna go buy it. We've got a bit of money to spend. It's not like money's all that. Why am I crouching? I was automatically going into steal everything mode. Hey, oh, there you go, right behind me, creeper. Yeah.
Can do.
Alright, I believe it should be under miscellaneous. Either that or weapons, because it might be a melee weapon. He doesn't. Okay. Nope, no shovels. Apparel? No. Shovel, 35. Ouch. Oh well, we do have some gecko hides. Oh, apparel. That's right, I can sell the Bolt 21 jumpsuit. And then miscellaneous dog hide. Jesus. Think about that for a second, though. Cheyenne, the dog, died defending Sunny Smiles and myself. And with Sunny Smiles standing right there, I skinned her dog, her freshly dead dog, while the body was still warm. I freaking skinned it right in front of her and just took the hide and then sold it to Chet, someone she personally knows from the same town she lives in. Holy shit. She doesn't react to that. I don't think the developers at Obsidian could possibly predict that and give you a line to dissuade you from such action. No, no, no. No, no, no. I mean, well, they probably could predict it, obviously. If you, if the hide is worth money and the dog dies, they could very well expect any player to, want to, you know, skin it and sell the hide. But, still, I think that's something that's a little bit too obscure to be worth putting in a paying your voice actor and writers and everything for that one extra little thing that's probably not going to be seen by most people. Because most people will probably play the game on normal mode, not hardcore mode. And then those people will likely not even see Cheyenne die. So the fact that they even put in the line for Sunny Smiles, being all like, "Damn it, Cheyenne, why'd you run in?" It's pretty commendable. Like much of this game. This entire game is commendable. It's amazing. It's probably one of my... It's one of, if not my favorite video game ever. It's like right up there with Demon's Souls, Dark Souls, Witcher 1 and The Witcher 3. Then you got Fallout New Vegas. All those, like, five. There you go. It's like my top five favorite video games ever. More or less. And Myst. There you go. Top six favorite video games. No particular order. But this is definitely up there. Oh, yes. Really nice, really pretty at night. Very pretty indeed. And not ridiculously dark. I think is there like a full moon, or do I just not? Maybe the Fallout mod is changed, or maybe I can't remember. I'm pretty sure that I have the same. I think it was part of the Fallout mod for Fallout 3 that makes you. That makes nights darker. And I have Fallout for Fallout New Vegas installed. So I wonder, oh boy, is this going to break my knees? Nope, thank God. So I wonder if it's different, or maybe it's a different mod that does that, and I don't actually have it installed. I don't remember. Hey, Sunny.
Let me see what you got. Yeah, these will do just fine. Just fine. All right, now. We're going to be making something folks on the trail call healing powder. Go on over to that campfire now. Give it a try.
Sure thing. Activate the campfire. Collect debris. Throwing. Oh yeah, so you can just basically, every campfire acts as a, it gives you throwing items. That's part of the, like, improved throwing weapons mod. Gecko steak. Healing powder. Alright. Create one of them.
Hey, that's not bad, see? All it takes to make a recipe is the right ingredients and the right know-how. Sometimes it won't be a campfire you need. Might need to do some work on your guns and ammo, maybe. Important thing to get is it's all the same idea. You just need to find the right place to set up shop. Workbench or reloading bench, whatever. Well, I hope that's enough to get you started. Okay. Well, good luck to you. I'm heading back to the Prospector. I could use a drink about now. Hey, do me a favor. Trudy, she's the bartender up at the Prospector. Kind of the town mom. She likes to meet newcomers. She'd be cross with me if I didn't ask you to poke your head in and say hi.
Sure thing, will do. And again, that's another unique line of dialogue. Her saying she needs a drink because Cheyenne died. That's, again, impressive. I've never heard it before. I'm happy. I'm happy to find new stuff. Okay, now let's cook some gecko steaks. Effects, cooked. H2O plus 2. Food, minus 77. HP plus 3 for 15 seconds. Alrighty. Yeah, let's make 7 of them. Obviously going to be better than the raw gecko steaks. Well, I say obviously, but who really knows? Hey, who the hell are you? Hello?
Hello? Can you help me?
What's wrong?
My girl is trapped by geckos on the ridge, and I can't get to her. Please, she's going to die.
Oh, is that the case? Where is she?
Go up the path, past the broken radio tower, and go to the right. They're at the top of the trail.
I'll see what I can do.
You will? Thank you for helping me. Please hurry.
Sure thing, buddy. You look entirely trustworthy. So I will do this task you've asked of me. Anything useful around here? No? Don't suppose I can... What do you got?
That doesn't belong to you.
Oh. Whoops. Again, I need a higher sneaking skill. Damn it. Alright, fine. Let's just go up. Before you venture deeper into the wasteland, you may revise your character. Nope. Finished. Travel onward. Let's just head on up here. I believe this is the correct way. Pretty sure I saw the little campsite that's going to be at the top that he was talking about. Alrighty. Stop shaking your arms. There you go. Where is it? Don't jam! Whew. How much freaking shotgun ammo do I have? I can't even... The freaking recording thing is on the bottom right corner. It's actually covering up my ammo counter. Oh boy, I might need to move that. well, we'll worry about that later. I guess, I think it's 11? Either 11 or 1. I guess we'll find out next time we use it. Alright, let's just get up on this hill. If we're up on a rock, it should give us a better angle for shooting these nasty lizards. Wow, how'd that miss? Oh god, reload. Whoops. How is this missing? What? No. Damn it. Alright, just stand still. No. Swear to God, there's nothing quite as frightening as having your gun jam right in the middle of trying to shoot the enemy, and now I'm out of ammo for the plasma pistol. Oh, great. Got plenty of ammo for this piece of shit, but nothing else for the plasma pistol. Alright, I could use more water, so I'm gonna drink some purified water to get Oh no, the broken water. Oh wait. Oh no, okay, so that's the... Yeah, that's the one for breaking. I don't know why it shows that weird broken picture. Great, that means the mod's messed up. Alright, oh well. And let's, healing powder, perception, minus one. I think the water should heal us, mostly. Let me look at my things real quick. Actually, we should equip this. Seven looks fine. Now, I'm out of ammo for this. Don't have any laser pistol ammo. Cleaver, nope. We've got three ammo, including what's loaded into it. Great! Alright, you know what? Let's, snipe it with this all we can. Get up a little higher. Oh, get some rock flowers first. Yummy, yummy. Make more healing power. Powder. Oh, crap. Where? Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Okay, let's, just do this. Reload. Yep, only one ammo. Alright, better make a count. Oh boy, that's a baby. Yeah, beat the shit out of him with a shovel. Damn. How'd you pieces of crap get behind me? Leveled up! Yeah! Alright. Now, I believe... Yeah, we have to go with repair first. I have my entire build carefully set out. Planned ahead of time. So there's specific skills that I need to increase first. Yeah, I don't remember what that is. Let's just ignore it. I seriously don't even know. I don't think it does anything, in fact. In fact, it's really weird, because when I was testing... I did some testing before I even started this playthrough. To, you know, make sure that I had, like, the right amount of skill points and everything to level up the things that I wanted to level up. And this didn't appear when I leveled up before. I'm not sure what caused that. Oh well, okay, so Black Widow. In combat, you do plus 10% damage against male opponents. Outside of combat, you'll sometimes have access to unique dialogue options when dealing with the opposite sex. Cherche la femme. In combat, you do plus 10% damage against female opponents. Outside of combat, you'll sometimes have access to unique dialogue options when dealing with the same sex. Okay, so we're going to be getting both of these, because, like I said, this is a character that's not really focused on combat. I'm mostly going to be trying to resolve problems through dialogue and stuff like that, if possible. And both of these give you more dialogue options, so we are going to be getting both of them. Plus, on the plus side, they give you plus 10% damage against certain people, and with both of them, you basically get plus 10% damage against all humans, and I believe it also affects ghouls. I don't see why it wouldn't. Now, we're going to get Black Widow first, because I believe male opponents are more common, especially if you're fighting Caesar's Legion. I think they're, like, all male. NCR is, like, pretty much 50-50 female and male. And, who are the other major groups? We're not going to be fighting any Brotherhood of Steel, but even just random raiders. Like, the random raiders in NCR are pretty much 50-50 male and female. But Caesar's Legion, if I remember correctly, is mostly just men. So this one's definitely going to give us more damage against a wider variety of enemies, so I'll get that one first. And I believe my head's crippled. Awesome. Nope, it's not, but it's damaged a bit. Okay. Huh. Alright, well, I guess we won't do anything with that right now, then. Let's heal up, though. Alright, Gecko Steak. Yeah. Let's eat two of those. I don't know how much health that's going to give us, but that takes our food down to... Why does it say N-U-T? Oh, nutrition. Okay. Nutrition, yeah, not food. I'm used to it. That's the way that N-U-T is the abbreviation for it with the like Project Nevada HUD options. I believe it normally says FOD for food in the main game. All right, let's take this and then drink some water to offset the H2O loss. Now everything should be back down to zero, and we should be getting our health back very soon. I am not left-handed, game. Please don't do this to me. All right, quick save. Yep, we're at pretty much. Oh boy, again already. Am I sneaking? Yes, I was. Well, obviously I'm sneaking. It wouldn't show me the caution message if I wasn't. Let's get up on the rocks. Again, that is a safe place to be. Oh, if we can. This might be too steep. Shit, 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 shit. Oh god. Okay, this works. Okay, I'm perfectly okay with this. Get away! Get away! Oh my god. Okay, where is he? I'll use Vats to finish him off before he hits me again. Jesus Christ, they do so much damage. I'm so glad I've been remembering the quick save. Is that him? No, that's the other one. Okay, let's heal up again, I guess. God damn. Yeah. I know, thanks game. You can't. Why does it give that same message? It just said... Wait, how do I... Hold up, game. Oh wait, I'm an idiot. I'm complaining about the frickin' thing giving me the wrong message saying he can sleep in a bed to heal crippled limbs, but I don't think you can do that in hardcore, and now I just forget that you also can't use stim packs to heal limbs in hardcore. You need a doctor's bag. Maybe sleeping in bed does work, then. Maybe I should have read the message. Oh well. Alright, let's see how much health this gives us. It was really weird the way he just teleported forward suddenly. Alright. Great, that didn't give us much. Alright, Sunset Sarsaparilla? Alright. Jesus Christ, we're gonna have that keep happening until we're, Alright, let's just move up to the same spot. We got most of our health back now. Our vision's gonna keep going blurry until we can fix our broken skull. Oh my god. There you go, that was the one. Alright, just stand still, please. Yes, like that. Thank you. Reload again. This is really stressful. At the, beginning of the game, when you're not doing much damage, and you're fighting these fast-moving melee enemies with lots of health... Yeah, it's kind of not great. He's trying to hide. But I can get him. I think I'm getting him. Oh, we'll shoot him in the back while he's running. Okay, let's move up. We're almost there. We're almost to the summit. Did he just die? did? What in the fuck happened? Oh, hey, we got even more health back. I guess the stuff took a while to take effect. I thought it healed faster than that. Alright. We are at the summit. Oh, and that guy's coming back, because we, rescued his girlfriend. Alright, so let's just quick save.
Sorry I tricked you, but thanks for clearing out the geckos. Now I can get to that stash up there, after I deal with you.
Oh, yeah? We'll see who gets dealt with. Oh, that's a shitty... I'm standing right next to the dude, and it's 15%. Oh, don't you dare. That's more like it. Come on, cripple his head. Sheesh. Alright, 9mm pistol, ammo, bottle cap. Merc cruiser outfit. You know what? Actually, I just realized, although it's barely anything, it's only +2, having the +2 guns may actually be more helpful than I give it credit for, just because it won't only increase our damage, it'll also increase our accuracy a little bit. And at this point in the game, when we have such low accuracy, I believe our gun skill is currently like 20 or something, or 19. It's 19, so yeah, with the thing we got 21, so yeah, it's just a little bit better. Regardless, this only gives one less damage threshold, and really, -1 damage threshold isn't anything to cry over. So, yeah. Oh wait, is that a melee weapon? No, it's junk. Okay. Alrighty. Geckos are all dealt with. Yeah, the geckos are actually much scarier enemies than humans. Because, like I said, again, you know, they've got quite a decent amount of health. They move very fast. And, they can do good damage, you know? I think that Wild Wasteland notification was for the red balls? I can't remember what... Or maybe it's the cards. I can't remember what it's about, but, ooh, boy, 119 rounds. And a 10mm pistol. Thank you, I'll just take all of that. And, okay, there's nothing in the footlocker? Oh. Do nothing, I guess? Rearm the trap? Pair skill's not high enough to interact with the trap. You need 55 or higher. So that's what killed the gecko. Glad we cleared that mystery up. He ran over the bear traps. I forgot the bear traps were even here. Alright. That's cool. Another good reason to get our repair skill up, though. Because we can do that. And, while we're at it, since we've got pretty decent repair skill, like 46, and we've got two of these 9mm pistols, let's repair one with the other. Get a little bit more damage out of them. And now, let's, we've still got a crippled head. Right. Yep, still got a crippled head that doesn't just go away on its own. Let's, sleep for a little bit. It's still crippled. Okay. I think... Oh boy. That's gonna be a problem. I think we can go to a doctor to get that fixed up. We can also... Maybe I'll have to push my sneak skill a little bit sooner than I was originally planning. Because, yeah... I think the best way to deal with getting our limbs broken might just be to not take damage. And the best way to do that would be to sneak around everywhere, kill enemies before they notice you. Yeah, I know for sure we can go to a doctor. I say for sure, but I might have forgotten as well on this point, and be utterly confused. Cactus water. Empty bottle. Prickly pear fruit. Minus H2O of 85. And, quite good HP healing. That'd be 15 HP, I guess. What's prickly pear fruit? How much does that heal? One for 10 seconds. So that's only 10 health. This reduces our food, reduces our H2O, but only by a little bit each. The other one will reduce our... It takes two prickly pear fruit, so it's not exactly an equal trade-off. I think actually we'd be better off with the two prickly pear fruit. And we've got an empty bottle, so we can just fill that with more water. But we are going to make more of those. We'll leave the... No, I don't want to cancel that, please. Thank you. I don't want to bother with the collecting debris. We're not going to be using throwing weapons at all. Throwing weapons are a little bit cumbersome in general. Yeah, we'll just refill this. I do have a mod, the improved throwing weapons thing, which is what allows me to collect the debris and throw it all around. Vision, please stop. Vision, please. Vision, stop it. But yeah, that does it changes the way throwing weapons work, so they're less cumbersome. But with such a low melee weapon skill like we have, it's not going to really matter. We're still going to be very inaccurate and not do much damage. And the whole problem, the entire deal with throwing weapons is that instead of having to worry about limited ammo, you've effectively got unlimited of them, but you have to constantly pick back up what you throw. And you don't have to worry about durability, but you have to potentially in the middle of combat go and pick up what you threw, so yeah, it's not something we're going to be bothering with for this character. Maybe if you're doing like a dedicated melee and throwing weapons character, then it'd be great, but otherwise it's not worth it. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it? We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out. Yeah, you better run. All right. And speaking of running, we're going to end this episode right about here. I think that's a good spot. When we come back, we'll learn what that argument was all about, and we'll go to Doc Mitchell and see if he can fix up our cracked skull. He already took a bullet out of our brain, so I think simply a cracked skull should be something he can deal with. So, yeah, but we'll do all that when we return. We'll see you all next time. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye-bye.